My name is Jackie Yatt. I'm a research ecologist with the Rocky Mountain Research Station in Rapid City, South Dakota. I specialize in grassland research, but I also work in the herbaceous understory of the Black Hills. When you look at grass, 99% of your stems in any grassland in North America come from below ground buds, not from seeds. So it's really important to understand where these buds come from, when are they produced, how long do they live, because this is determines the resistance and resilience of our grasslands to disturbance. We recently got funded with the Joint Fire Science Program to look at regeneration following fire of key forb species and key grass species in western South Dakota and eastern Wyoming. So that will occur on Thunder Basin National Grassland and also Buffalo Gap National Grassland. And it is actually a collaborative effort between the U.S. Geological Survey, the USDA Agriculture Research Service, Colorado State University, University of Wyoming, and also our Fire Sciences Lab in Missoula. And with that research, we'll be able to answer some of the key questions on how well do the plants of the Great Plains regenerate after fire for key species, for pollinators, for sage grouse. We'll also be able to just look at good grass and how does it regenerate for grazing and all our grazing permittees that occur on the national grasslands. When you want to elucidate the bud bank life history of a certain species, what you need to do is you go out in the field and you find a population of the species of interest. We'll say blue grama, for example. You will dig up a core about 15 centimeters deep. You'll get multiple individual cores. You'll take those cores back to the lab, to the microscope. You'll wash out all the dirt and the soil, and then you'll look for the axillary and adventitious buds that might be occurring on those species. And then the way to elucidate that life history is you have to go back to that same population multiple times over the course of a year, so you'll be able to look at how those buds have changed over time, and when are those buds being formed, how are those buds developing over time. And then, once you know that life history of that species, you can think, oh, if disturbance is happening at a certain time, whether it's in the spring or in the fall, if you have spring fire, maybe that encourages bud production, or maybe that would be detrimental to bud production, or maybe that would delay bud production. But once you know the basic life history, you can better understand how disturbances can impact those species.